Ano ba, ay, una-una, tanungin natin, magkakaroon po ba ng National Assembly ang PDP Laban next week o hindi?
Well, sir, sa mata po ng liderato ng partido, sa mata ng karamihan na aming mga kapartido, sa mata po ng constitutional bylaws ng partido natin, wala pong assembly, walang council meeting na mangyayari on Monday. Kung may magagather doon, that will be considered as one of the ordinary meetings or informal meetings ng partido. Anything na mapag-usapan doon is unofficial.
Sa perception namin, medyo malaki yung hidwaan dahil it involves top officials of the party. At saka medyo nagkaka-split dahil one side is endorsing, yung tingin namin na may endorsement pa malaki niya. Di ba? And it's not the first time na nagsalita si Senator Pacquiao about something that's happening within the party. Noong March, nag-warning din siya na bakit daw nagsasign ng resolution urging President Duterte to run as Vice President. Di ba? So maybe you can clarify those issues, no? Meron bang malalim na split or there's a growing rift within the party or it's, well, sabi niyo nga, it's just a misunderstanding. Pero yun, ang tingin nga namin, medyo malalim na. Ano po yung
nangyayari? Opo, sa mata po namin sa leadership ng partido, again, this is a simple misunderstanding and sana nga po maayos natin ito agad-agad. We would like to appeal to some of our party mates led by our beloved vice chairman na sana wag muna tayo mamulitika ngayon. Dahil po marami, sabi nga po ni Senator Manny Pacquiao, marami gutom na mga kababayan natin ngayon, marami tayong mga may sakit na kababayan, marami pang matataas pang cases ng COVID, at nakakaya naman po kung politika ang pag-usapan natin this early, as early as May. Tapos po, we will uproot our local chief executives, our governors, our mayors, our party mates, some of our congressmen, to go to Cebu and to discuss politics. Nakakaya naman po yun. Wala naman po problema sa pagpapatawag ng National Council. Pero una-una, sundin muna natin yung bylaws ng partido. Because ang pwede lang po magpatawag ng isang council or assembly ay ang ating party chairman na si Pangulong Duterte at ang ating party president si Senator Manny Pacquiao lamang. And sir, kailangan parehas po sila magpatawag. Hindi po ang ating vice chairman. First. Second, again, I will repeat, medyo off po talaga yung timing na magkwentuhan tayo, mag-usap-usap tayo about the 2022 presidential elections, abang marami tayong mga kababayan na nagugutom at may sakit.
Sir, we understand, of course, where you're coming from. The point of view of pandemic being primary among other issues. Pero ito po ang sabi ni Secretary Melvin Matibag sa isang interview, I think, with ANC earlier. Ang sabi niya, number one, it's not a National Assembly, it's an Executive Council meeting. I'm not sure about the nuancing there, kung ano kaibahan doon. At kung executive council meeting ba, pwede silang magtawag ng meeting na walang paalam from the president and the chairman, o iba pa yun doon sa general meeting. Number two, may paramdam si Mr. Matibag na the meeting is being called at the behest of the president because si Secretary Cusi daw is the vice chair and also a member of the president's cabinet. So meron siyang ganung paramdam. At number three, ito po yung mas medyo sensitibo, sabi niya, they need to meet to decide who sits as party president. Dahil si Manny Pacquiao daw, acting president lamang. So may paramdam din na maaring matanggal si Senator Manny as president. So yun po, those three things. Where does the party stand here?
Okay, Sir Ed. First po, ang pinapatawag po nila Vice Chairman Cusi is what we call a National Council meeting, the meeting body of the party. Ang pwede lang po magpatawag po nun is our party chairman and our party president Manny Pacquiao. Meaning, our chairman and president must sit down.
Together.
They will have to fix the agenda of the National Council meeting. They have to sit down together and then they will call for the National Council meeting. Not the vice chairman, not the SecGen, not me, or not any politician, nor any party member.
that applies to the executive council, two, sir, no? That also applies to the executive council, kasi that's what he called it, the executive council.
Yes, but well, it's a national council meeting, sir, because the executive committee is another body. It's a smaller body naman po. And then, sir, to answer your question, we have the constitution and bylaws of the PDP-Laban for a reason. Ang hirap naman po maging assuming na just because member of the cabinet or just because by chairman, si chairman na po nagpapatawag. We are governed by our constitution and bylaws, and assuming patawag po talaga ito ni chairman, but he has to work with our party president. If may patawag, if party president pa kayo wants to follow on a meeting, he has to work with the chairman. This is a system designed to be highly democratic. Hindi tayo, we have to remember, PDP-Laban was born out of its fight against
the anti-dictatorship fight.
Dictatorship. Yes. Also, let's not forget our rules. Let's not forget our roots also. So, yan po ang ating, babalik lang po, huwag tayo maging assuming na porkit po ay member ng kabinet or vice chairman, patawag na po ni chairman. Napakahirap po nun. Kaya mawawala po tayo sa direksyon yan. And number three, again, sinasabi po, and number three, baka po mapalitan yung mga officers. Again, babalik po tayo. Tama po ba na mag-usap-usap tayo ng politika sa gitna ng pandemya? Tama po ba na papuntay natin mga gobernador, mga mayor, mga appointed officials natin sa isang lugar para mag-usap ng politika this early? May tamang panahon naman po dyan. And at yung tamang panahon natin is maybe 1 month before elections. I mean, sorry, 1 month before
the filing
of candidates in September. And then, we've been, Ma'am Amy, regularly meeting with our party mates. The PDP-Laban is 100,000 strong. 95% of these 100,000 members are all from the grassroots. In fact, we've been meeting with several chapters already, and then we have a huge number of our grassroots members already declaring their support for Manny Pacquiao as your party president. Mm-hmm. In fact, we have boxes of this already. These are all from our grassroots members supporting the party presidency of Manny Pacquiao. So, again, hindi po kami natatakot. Wag na lang ipalabas na natatakot kami sa election. Ang amin lang, yung timing lang po. Nahihiya po kami sa...
Yeah.
Yes, sir?
Yes, Mr. Munsayac, we're hearing from you. You're executive director. We've heard from the president, Manny Pacquiao. We heard from the vice chairman. All of this, however, still begs the question, what is the chairman saying in all of this? Nagsalita po ba? Kinausap na po ba kayo? Have you talked to the president? President Duterte, I mean.
We have yet to personally talk with our chairman, President Duterte. But I will give you this information firsthand. This afternoon, Senator, our party president, Manny Pacquiao, spoke with Senator Bongo. As we all know, Senator Bongo is the closest, and probably one of the closest persons with President Digong. So Senator Bongo assured Senator Manny Pacquiao that he will not attend this National Council meeting. The other senators also, Senator Bato, Senator Tolentino, and most importantly, Senator Pimentel, who is a founding member of the party, will not attend this said National Council meeting. So, Sir Roby, balik lang po ako. Pagdating po sa katanungan po, kung ano pong nasasabi po ni Chairman Duterte, we have yet to speak to him, sir. But I think yung words po o yung assurance ni Senator Bongo is already strong enough.
Yes, sir. I understand your point. Pero yun din kasi, one of their avowed intentions for their meeting is to decide on who sits as the president of the party. So even, I mean, like it or not, now they're putting into question Senator Manny Pacquiao's stint as acting president of the party. So for all intents and purposes, it might be a coup d'etat in the party.
Well, sir. Well, again, number one, we would really question the body. First, authorized po ba yung pagpapatawag ng ating vice chairman? Answer is no. Second, who are the attendees? May quorum po ba? We believe baka wala. Third, members in good standing po ba ang mga member ang mag-attend dito? Kasi actually, pwede naman sila maghatak-hatak kung san-san po. So, it's just the same po as, kunwari, merong grupo ng mga tao sa dyan sa labas ng ating bahay, they will magsama-sama sila, tapos mag-i-elect sila ng bagong mayor dyan sa bayan nila. Pero hindi pa naman ho eleksyon. So parang ganun lang po eh, parang ganun lang po yung tingin namin. This is an informal meeting sa mata po ng leadership ng party.